Welcome to another training video. In this video, we are going to see how to configure a Danfoss FC51 VFD and how to run it. Today, we will learn how to run motor with VFD using a potentiometer as a speed reference. Potentiometer analog signal will be used to control the speed of the motor. Before starting, I would like you guys to please subscribe this channel for some amazing upcoming video tutorials. Before going into the parameter settings of the VFD, we have to understand how and where to connect start push button and potentiometer to the Danfoss FC51 VFD. So let's quickly start today's tutorial. If we open the front cover of the VFD, here we will find a terminal strip. This strip is used to connect inputs and output devices to the VFD. The terminals on this strip have a specific number and parameter assigned to it to configure the functions for these I/O terminals. The terminal 12 and terminal 20 are supplying out 24 volt DC for the I/O devices. Terminal number 18 to terminal number 33 are the digital inputs. These inputs are programmable as per our operation requirements. Parameters 5, 10 to 5, 15 are used to program functions like start, stop, reverse and reset, errors, etc. for these digital inputs. Terminal 42 is here to generate an analog output which will be 4 to 20 milliamps signal. This signal can be programmed to show output voltage, current, frequency or the RPM of the motor. Terminals 50, 53 and 55 is used to connect a potentiometer to the VFD to inject 0 to 10 volts analog signal at the analog input of the VFD. Terminal 53 analog input can be configured and programmed as a frequency reference input using parameter menu 315 and menu 61. To keep the things really simple for the today's tutorial, we will use a selector switch as a start signal and connect it at the terminal number 18. The functions for the terminal 18 can be programmed by using the parameter menu 510. We can select a function for the terminal 18 from the menu, like start, stop, reverse, and reset functions. For today's tutorial, we will set 8 in the parameter 510 to program this terminal as start signal input. Now, the next thing is to connect a potentiometer at terminal 53, which is an analog input with 0 to 10 volt signal. We can connect 3 wires of the potentiometers at terminal 50, 53 and 55. Now, when VFD is powered on and we rotate the potentiometer, it will inject 0 to 10 volts variable signal at analog input terminal 53. We can use the parameter 315, the reference source, to configure this analog input as a frequency reference input. We can select 1 to configure this analog input as a reference frequency source. There are two other parameters which I want to discuss here are the minimum and the maximum reference, which are 3, 2 and 3, 3 parameters. These two parameters defines the minimum speed of the motor at 0 volt analog input signal and maximum speed at 10 volts analog input signal. For this example, I set 0 Hz speed at 0 volt analog input signal and 100 Hz at 10 volts analog input signal. Just a side note here, the speed of the motor will not exceed the speed which we have entered in the parameter 414, which is a maximum speed limit. If we want to run at higher speeds, we have to increase the speed limit in the parameter 414. In the next step, we have to set the acceleration and deacceleration time for the motor in the VFD using the parameter 341 and 342. Acceleration time is a time in which motor goes from 0 RPM to its maximum RPM. It depends how big the motor is and how much the direct shaft load is connected to it. It can be set between 3 to 15 seconds. Deacceleration time is a time in which motor goes from its maximum RPM to 0 RPM. Again, it depends upon the motor size and how much load we have connected to it. It can be set between 1 to 5 seconds. Now, the most of the basic parameter settings is done in the VFD settings. In the next step, we have to enter the motor nameplate parameters in the VFD. Mostly, these parameters include motor power in kilowatt or HP, motor voltage, motor current, and motor RPM. After entering these parameters in the VFD, we are ready to start the motor using a run command via selector switch and a potentiometer as a frequency reference source. Now, if we turn on the selector switch, the VFD goes into the run mode, but the motor is not running yet because the potentiometer is set to the zero and the analog reference signal is also zero. If we turn the potentiometer to the 10, the motor starts to run and goes slowly from 0 to 10 Hz speed. Now, if we again turn the potentiometer to 30, the motor starts to run and goes slowly from 10 Hz to 30 Hz speed. Now, if we turn the selector switch off, the motor goes into the stop mode, and the motor slowly starts to deaccelerate and goes from 30 Hz to 0 Hz speed. So this is how we can use a FC51 Danfoss VFD by configuring some parameters in the VFD settings. I hope you like today's tutorial. Do consider subscribing to this channel. Till next video, take care and goodbye.